Good morning, brothers and sisters. On this Palm Sunday, which is also Alay Kapwa Sunday, we unveil and bless the image of the homeless Jesus donated to the Manila Cathedral. The homeless Jesus is a three-dimensional sculpture cast in bronze by Canadian artist Timothy P. Schmalz. The artwork depicts Jesus, identifiable by the wounds on his feet, sleeping on a street bench wrapped in a blanket. It became somewhat viral because it portrayed Jesus in a relatable human context, allowing people to feel a greater closeness with and accessibility to Christ. For the artist, the sculpture is like a visual sermon 24 hours a day. The realistic statue of a homeless Jesus outside the Manila Cathedral can hopefully inspire reflections and conversations on how we care for the poor and homeless in the community. This sculpture challenges what Pope Francis calls the throwaway culture that ignores and abuses the poor and the voiceless ones. May this sculpture not only become a place for visits or pictures, but a space to deepen our prayer and to convert and change our hearts. As we look at Jesus who is homeless, may we also see the poor who, according to Pope Francis, paid the price of corruption, and so lead us to choose competent and honest leaders this coming national elections. We thank the artist, Timothy P. Schmalz, for choosing the Manila Cathedral for his sculpture. Our deep gratitude to the patron who generously donated the image and to Mr. Eric Katabihan for facilitating this project. We also thank His Excellency Peter MacArthur, Ambassador of Canada to the Philippines, for his presence today. Ambassador MacArthur and Father Malikdem will now unveil the image to be followed by the rite of blessing to be presided by Cardinal Jose Advincula. Please all stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
To you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, Whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dearly beloved brothers and sisters, let us pray to God Almighty Father, who has revealed to us his glory in Christ, so that we may be conformed to his image. Blessed are you, Lord, source and fountain of every blessing. You are gladdened by the intense piety of your faithful ones. Be present, we pray, in your mercy to your servants, and grant that we bless this image depicting your Son, who humbled himself and became poor and homeless. We may imitate his humility. Our hearts may be moved with compassion. Our hands may reach out to others in service, and our lives be transformed into the image of your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now face towards the back of the church as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, since the beginning of Lent until now, we have prepared our hearts by penance and charitable works. Today we gather together to herald with the whole Church the beginning of the celebration of our Lord's Paschal Mystery, that is to say, of his Passion and Resurrection. For it was to accomplish this mystery that he entered his own city of Jerusalem. Therefore, with all faith and devotion, let us commemorate the Lord's entry into the city for our salvation, following in his footsteps, so that being made by his grace partakers of the cross, we may have a share also in his resurrection and in his life. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, sanctify these branches with your blessing, that we who follow Christ the King in exaltation may reach the eternal Jerusalem through him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus proceeded on his journey up to Jerusalem. As he drew near to Bethphage and Bethany, at the place called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples. He said, "Go into the village opposite you, and as you enter it, you will find a colt tethered on which no one has ever sat. Untie it and bring it here. And if anyone should ask you, 'Why are you untying it?' you will answer, 'The master has need of it.' So those who had been sent went off and found everything just as he had told them. And as they were untying the colt, its owners said to them, "Why are you untying this colt?" They answered, "The master has need of it." So they brought it to Jesus, threw their cloaks over the colt, and helped Jesus to mount. As he rode along, the people were spreading their cloaks on the road. And now, as he was approaching the slope of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of his disciples began to praise God aloud with joy for all the mighty deeds they had seen. They proclaimed, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, "Teacher, rebuke your disciples." He said in reply, "I tell you, if they keep silent, the stones will cry out." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, like the crowds who acclaimed Jesus in Jerusalem, let us go forth in peace.
In the name of Christ, amen. Please raise and wave your palms for the blessing.
Oh,
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who as an example of humility for the human race to follow, caused our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may heed his lesson of patient suffering and so merit a share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary, a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, he opens my ear, that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help. Therefore, I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
the midst of the assembly I will praise you. You who fear the Lord, praise him. All you descendants of Jacob, give glory to him. Revere him, all you descendants of Israel.
Reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Philippians. Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave. Coming in human likeness and found human in appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. The elders of the people, chief priests and scribes, arose and brought Jesus before Pilate. They brought charges against him, saying,
"We found this man misleading our people. He opposes the payment of taxes to Caesar and maintains that he is the Christ, a king."
Pilate asked him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
"You say so."
Pilate then addressed the chief priests and the crowds.
"I find this man not guilty."
But they were adamant and said,
"He is inciting the people with his teaching throughout all Judea, from Galilee, where he had begun even to hear."
On hearing this, Pilate asked if the man was a Galilean, and upon learning that he was under Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him to Herod, who was in Jerusalem at that time. Herod was very glad to see Jesus. He had been wanting to see him for a long time, for he had heard about him and been hoping to see him perform some sign. He questioned him at length, but he gave no answer. The chief priests and scribes, meanwhile, stood by accusing him harshly. Herod and his soldiers treated him contemptuously and mocked him. And after clothing him in resplendent garb, he sent him back to Pilate. Herod and Pilate became friends that very day, even though they had been enemies formerly. Pilate then summoned the chief priests, the rulers, and the people, and said to them,
"You brought this man to me and accused him of inciting the people to revolt. I have conducted my investigation in your presence and have not found this man guilty of the charges you have brought against him, nor did Herod, for he sent him back to us. So, no capital crime has been committed by him. Therefore, I shall have him flogged and then release him."
But altogether they shouted out,
"Away with this man! Release Barabbas to us!
Barabbas! We want Barabbas!"
Now, Barabbas had been imprisoned for a rebellion that had taken place in the city and for murder. Again, Pilate addressed them, still wishing to release Jesus, but they continued their shouting,
"Crucify him!
Crucify him!
Crucify him!"
Pilate addressed them a third time,
"What evil has this man done? I found him guilty of no capital crime. Therefore, I shall have him flogged and then release him."
With loud shouts, however, they persisted in calling for his crucifixion, and their voices prevailed. The verdict of Pilate was that their demand should be granted. So he released the man who had been imprisoned for rebellion and murder, for whom they asked, and he handed Jesus over to them to deal with as they wished. As they led him away, they took hold of a certain Simon, a Cyrenian, who was coming in from the country. And after laying the cross on him, they made him carry it behind Jesus. A large crowd of people followed Jesus, including many women who mourned and lamented him. Jesus turned to them and said,
"Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me. Weep instead for yourselves and for your children. For indeed, the days are coming when people will say, 'Blessed are the barren, the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never nursed.' At that time, people will say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hills, 'Cover us.' For if these things are done when the wood is green, what will happen when it is dry?"
Now, two others, both criminals, were led away with him to be executed. When they came to the place called the Skull, they crucified him and the criminals there, one on his right, the other on his left. Then Jesus said,
"Father, forgive them. They know not what they do."
They divided his garments by casting lots. The people stood by and watched. The rulers, meanwhile, sneered at him and said,
"He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the chosen one, the Christ of God."
Even the soldiers jeered at him. As they approached to offer him wine, they called out,
"If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself."
Above him, there was an inscription that read, "This is the King of the Jews." Now,
one of the criminals hanging there reviled Jesus, saying,
"Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us."
The other, however, rebuking him, said in reply,
"Have you no fear of God? For you are subject to the same condemnation. And indeed, we have been condemned justly, for the sentence we receive corresponds to our crimes. But this man has done nothing criminal."
Then he said,
"Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom."
He replied to him,
"Amen, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise."
It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon because of an eclipse of the sun. Then the veil of the temple was torn down the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"Father, into your hands I commend my spirit."
And when he had said this, he breathed his last. We all kneel. We all stand. The centurion who witnessed what had happened glorified God and said,
"This man was innocent beyond doubt."
When all the people who had gathered for this spectacle saw what had happened, they returned home beating their breasts. But all his acquaintances stood at a distance, including the women who had followed him from Galilee and saw these events. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated.
Happened, they returned home beating their breasts. But all his acquaintances stood at a distance.
My dear brother priests and deacons, His Excellency the Ambassador of Canada to the Philippines, Mr. Peter MacArthur, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, with today's celebration of Palm Sunday, we enter into the Holy Week at nagpapasalamat tayo sa Diyos dahil sa pagkatapos ng 2 taon na nagkaroon ng hard lockdown sa panahon ng Holy Week. Hindi kayo nakapunta sa mga simbahan at ang mga pagdiriwang natin ay online lang. Sa taong ito, nandito tayo ngayon at magkakasama. Sigurado akong na-miss ninyong lahat ang mag-Holy Week sa inyong mga parokya. Kaya naman sana, habang nag-iingat pa din, pumunta tayo sa ating mga simbahan makiisa tayo sa mga gawain, taimtim tayong magdasal, at makahulugang ipagdiwang ang mga dakilang misteryo ng ating pananampalataya, ang pagpapakasakit, pagkamatay, at muling pagkabuhay ng ating Panginoong Hesus. Palm Sunday is unique because it is the only Mass with two Gospels. The first Gospel is proclaimed at the blessing of the palms at the beginning of the Mass. And the second Gospel is the long narrative of the Passion of the Lord. And I am sure if you have observed it, but in these two Gospels, it seems that there are a lot of shouting. Maraming sigawan sa dalawang ebanghelyong narinig natin ngayong araw na ito. In the Gospel at the beginning of our celebration, Jesus enters the holy city of Jerusalem, and the people praise God aloud with joy as they shout, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." Nagsisigaw sila sa galak bilang pagsalubong kay Jesus. When the Pharisees told Jesus to ask his disciples to shut up, Jesus answers them, "If they keep silent, the stone will cry out." Kung tatahimik sila, ang mga bato naman ang sisigaw. Walang makakapigil sa mga tao na isigaw ang pagpupuri sa Panginoon. This is similar to what St. Paul tells us in our second reading today. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord, to the glory of God the Father. In the Passion narrative, we also hear people shouting, not out of joy, but out of anger and hatred. The elders of the people, chief priests and scribes, are throwing accusations against Jesus. The crowds are shouting, "Away with this man! Release Barabbas! Crucify him!" Sumisigaw sila dahil sa galit nila kay Jesus. Sumisigaw sila bilang paghuhusga kay Jesus. They are so angry with Jesus that they want to get rid of him. They want him dead. In the first kind of shouting as a sign of welcome and praise. The second is an expression of hatred. The first is recognition. The second is condemnation. These kinds of shouting are still very much present even in our times. Some people shout, "Hosanna," to welcome, praise, and proclaim Jesus. But some cry, "Crucify him," because they want to get rid of Jesus. What are we shouting? Ano ba ang isinisigaw natin ngayon? Ang sigaw ba natin ay Osana, tanda ng ating saya sa pagtanggap kay Jesus? Ang sigaw ba natin ay sigaw ng pagbibigay ng parangal at papuri kay Jesus? O ang isinisigaw ba natin ay ipako siya sa krus? Ang sigaw ba natin ay puno ng galit? Ang sigaw ba natin ay upang ipagtabuyan si Jesus? Nakakalungkot mang aminin, pero mukhang mas malakas ang sigaw na mga laban kay Jesus kaysa sa mga tumatanggap kay Jesus. Tila baga mas malakas ang sigaw ng mga nagsasabing ipako siya sa krus kaysa mga buong galak na sumisigaw ng Osana. Jesus and faith in Him seem not to be given much importance. Kapag para sa business, economy, industry, malakas ang sigaw ng Osana. Kapag para sa pera, kayamanan, posisyon, kapangyarihan at kasikatan, napakalakas ng sigaw ng Osana. Para sa mga taong iniidolo at tinitingala natin, malakas ang sigaw natin ng Osana. Pero bakit kapag para sa Diyos, kapag para sa ating pananampalataya, kapag para sa katotohanan at katarungan, bakit parang pabulong-bulong lang tayo? O pinatatahimik ang ating pagsigaw? Nilunod na ba ng mga sigaw ng makamundong Osana ang Osana natin para sa Diyos? My dear brothers and sisters, do we still have the courage to shout out loud our praises for God? In today's first reading, the suffering servant says, "The Lord has given me a well-trained tongue that I might know how to speak to the weary a word that will rouse them." May God also give us a well-trained and adequately tamed tongue so that we may know how to speak and shout out Jesus to the world. Palm Sunday is also Alay Kapwa Sunday. We are invited to listen to the tiny voices of our brothers and sisters who are in need of our care, support, and love. Before the Mass, we unveiled and blessed the homeless Jesus sculpture permanently installed at the patio of our cathedral. More than a work of art, the statue of the homeless Jesus, according to its artist, Tim Schmalz, is a virtual sermon 24 hours a day. Ang imahen ng homeless Jesus ay nangungusap sa atin, sumisigaw sa atin na marinig ang tinig ni Jesus
at makita siya sa mga kapatid nating walang lugar sa ating lipunan at walang lugar sa ating puso. Mamaya, pagkatapos ng misa, tingnan ninyo ang statue. Pwede kayong umupo sa tabi ni Jesus at magpakuha ng picture. Pero sana huwag lang kayong magpa-picture. Pagmasdan ninyo itong mabuti. Tingnan ninyo si Jesus. Pakinggan ninyo ang sinasabi at isinisigaw niya. At tumugon tayo sa kanya sa pamamagitan ng ating pag-ibig at malasakit para sa isa't isa. My brothers and sisters, today we begin Holy Week, the most important week for every Christian. Amid all the meaningless noises around us, this week, let us shout out loud, Hosanna to the Son of David, so that we can defeat those who shout, Crucify Him. Let us cry out to the whole world through our lips and lives that Jesus Christ is Lord and that He alone is the Savior of the world. Amen.
Please stand.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us invoke the perfect sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ, who was crucified and died, and humbly beseech God to hear our prayer. Let us say, Lord, in your mercy, hear us.
Lord, in your mercy, hear us.
For the whole Christian people, that the palms may symbolize our commitment to follow Christ's example of offering himself on the cross, that we may learn likewise to offer our time, talent, and treasure to God, and for the good of our brothers and sisters, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, in your mercy, hear us.
For the whole world, that all people may learn that selfishness and self-centeredness lead to a dead end, and it is in sharing oneself and being oriented towards others that there can be lasting joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, in your mercy, hear us.
For a swift end to the coronavirus pandemic that afflicts our world, that our God and Father will heal the sick, strengthen those who care for them, and help us all to persevere in faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, in your mercy, hear us.
For peace in the world, and for those who suffer because of the scourge of war, especially in Ukraine, that God may cleanse the world from all violence and misuse of power, so that all may live in tranquility and freedom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, in your mercy, hear us.
For our community, that we may choose to walk with Christ, stay with Christ in prayer, and stand at the foot of the cross, and so also share in the joy, salvation, and glory of Easter. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, in your mercy, hear us.
Loving God, you showed us the depth of your love in the sacrifice of Christ. Through your Son's offering, we lift up to you the prayer of your people. Make us one with him, so that we may follow him and share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Today is Alay Kapwa Sunday. Our offerings for this Mass will be given to the charitable projects of the Church for the Poor.
We are.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Through the passion of your only begotten Son, O Lord, may our reconciliation with you be near at hand, so that though we do not merit it by our own deeds, yet by the sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For though innocent, he suffered willingly for sinners and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death has washed away our sins, and his resurrection has purchased our justification. And so with all the angels, in joyful celebration, we too acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Amen.
as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, all the bishops, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, you have brought us to hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection, you may lead us to where you call. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We have acclaimed Jesus as the Son of David, entering Jerusalem in glory. Let us follow him on the way of his cross by our self-sacrificing love for others.
Thanks be to God.